Hello students, now moving further in geometrical optics, in this video we will discuss about multiple reflection in case of inclined plane mirror. As already discussed in the previous video, multiple reflection in case of inclined mirrors will happen when a ray of light incident on any of the mirror will get reflected from that mirror such that after reflection it will again be incident on other mirror. Hence, in this case we have multiple reflection and there will be multiple image formation for the same object. For inclined mirrors, we may have mirrors inclined at an acute angle, at right angle or at an obtuse angle. Now let's start discussion about mirrors inclined at right angle. Here we have an object O placed such that its distance from M1 mirror is x and from M2 mirror is also x, or we can say that the object is placed symmetrically with respect to both the mirrors. Now let's form an image from M1 mirror. Here we have two incident rays and two reflected rays. Now image will be formed behind the mirror. As the distance of object from M1 mirror is x, so the distance of image from M1 mirror will also be x, and distance of object from M2 mirror is x, so this image distance from M2 mirror will also be x. Also, let's call this image I1. Again, now let's form image of this object from M2 mirror. Here we have two incident and reflected rays and image formed somewhere over here. Let's call this image as I2. Also here, as we have object distance from mirror M2 as x, so the image will also be at a distance of x units, and object is at a distance x units from mirror M1. Hence, this image will also be at a distance of x units from mirror M1. Here in this case, we can see that there will be some rays incident on M1 which after getting reflected from M1 mirror will again be incident on M2 mirror. Hence, the image I1 formed from the M1 mirror will act as a source for M2 mirror. Also, there will be some rays which upon incident on M2 mirror will get reflected towards the mirror M1. So, this image I2 will also act as a source for M1 mirror. Now, as the image I1 will act as a source for M2 mirror, so it will again form an image from M2 mirror. Now, taking I1 as object for M2 mirror, let's form an image. Here, we have an incident ray on M2 and reflected ray. Take again another incident ray from object to M1 mirror such that after reflection it will be incident on M2 mirror too. Here we have another reflected ray from M2 mirror and the image will form somewhere over here. Let's call this image I3. Also here we can see that the object distance or the I1 image distance from M1 mirror is x and from M2 mirror is also x. Hence I3 distance from M1 mirror will be x and from M2 mirror will be x2. Also we have image I2 which will act as a source for M1 mirror. So let's form an image of this I2 from M1 mirror. Here we have one incident ray on M1 mirror and reflected ray. Let's take another incident ray from object on mirror M2 such that after reflection from mirror M2 it will again be incident on mirror M1. Hence here we have reflected ray for the same and the image formed will be somewhere over here. Also in this case we can see that the I2 image is at a distance of x units from mirror M1 and at a distance of x units from mirror M2 too. Hence this image formed will also be at a distance of x units from mirror M1 and x units from mirror M2. Here we can see that both these images formed are at the exact same location. Hence this image will also be I3, and now this image I3 is behind both the mirrors. Hence now it will never act as an object for any of these mirrors. Also here in this case the total number of images formed will be equal to 3. Also in this case the image I3 is formed when the incident ray from the object after getting reflected from one of the mirrors is again incident on another mirror. Hence the image I3 is formed by two reflections, and also it is formed by both the mirrors. As for image I1 and I2, these both are formed by single reflection and from the single mirror. Also here we can see that the object and the images are all at equal distances from the point of intersection of mirror. Hence taking point of intersection of mirror as center, if we draw a circle then it will pass from the object and all the images. Also the radius of the circle will be equal to the object distance from the intersection point of both the mirror, and in this case it will be equal to under root of x square plus x square or under root of 2x square or equal to root 2 times x. Now let's discuss another case. In this case, the object is placed at a distance of x units from mirror M1 and y units from mirror M2. Or we can say that the object is placed unsymmetrically with respect to both these mirrors. Now let's form an image of this object from mirror M2. Here we have two incident ray and reflected ray, and the image form will be over here. Let's call this image I1. Also, as we can see, the object distance from mirror M1 is x units, hence image will also be at a distance of x units from mirror M1, and the object distance from mirror M2 is y units, hence the image I1 formed will also be at a distance of y units from mirror M2. Now let's form an image from mirror M2. Here we have two incident rays and two reflected rays, and the image form will be somewhere over here. Let's call this image as I2. Now the object is at a distance of y unit from mirror M2. Hence this image I2 form will also be at a distance of y units from mirror M2. Also the object is at a distance of x units from mirror M1. Hence this image I2 form will also be at a distance of x units from mirror M1. Also in this case, we can see that there are some incident rays which after reflection from mirror M1 will again be incident on mirror M2. Hence this image I1 form will act as a source for M2 mirror. Also there are some incident rays on mirror M2 which upon reflection will again be incident on M1 mirror. Hence this image I2 will also be act as a source for M1 mirror. Now taking I1 as a source for M2 mirror, let's form an image. Here we have one incident ray and reflected ray, and here we have another incident ray from object such that after get reflected from mirror M1, it will again be incident on mirror M2. Here we have reflected ray and the image form will be somewhere over here. Let's call this image I3. Here we can see that the I1 is at a distance of y units from mirror M2. Hence this image I3 forms will also be at a distance of y units from mirror M2. Also the distance of I1 from mirror M1 is x units. Hence I3 formed will also be at a distance of x units from mirror M1. Now taking I2 as an object for M1 mirror, let's form an image. Here we have one incident ray and reflected ray. Now take another incident ray object on mirror M2 such that after reflection it will again be incident on mirror M1. Hence here we have incident ray on mirror M1 and reflected ray, and the image form will be somewhere over here. Also in this case, as I2 is acting as an object for this image and I2 distance from mirror M2 is y unit, hence this image form will also be at a distance of y units from mirror M2. And also I2 is at a distance of x units from mirror M1, hence this image formed will also be at a distance of x units from mirror M1. In this case too, we can see that the image formed over here and this image form are at the exact same locations. Hence, this image will also be I3. Or we can say that the image formed in both these cases are overlapping. Also, the I3 is now behind both the mirrors. Hence, it will now never act as an object for any of these mirrors. And in this case too, the total image form will be equal to 3. Now, in this case, we can see that I3 is formed when incident ray from the object after getting reflected from any of the mirror is again incident on other mirror. Hence, the image I3 is formed by two reflections and it is also formed by both the mirrors. As for image I1 and I2, these both are formed by single reflection and single mirror. Also, in this case, as we can see that the object distance and the distance of all the images from the point of intersection of mirrors is equal. Hence, if taking point of intersection of mirrors as center, and if we draw a circle, it will pass through the object and all of these images, and radius of this circle will be equal to object distance from the point of intersection of mirror, and in this case it will be equal to under root of x square plus y square. Hence here we can see that in case the mirrors are inclined at right angle, if the object is placed symmetrically with respect to both the mirrors or unsymmetrically with respect to both the mirrors, the image formed in both the cases will be equal to 3, and distance of images from the point of intersection of mirrors will be equal, and this distance of image from point of intersection of mirror will be equal to object distance from the point of intersection of mirrors. Also, in the case when the object is placed symmetrically, here if we join object and all the images, then it will form a square, and the side length of this square will be equal to 2 times x units or 2 times the image distance from any of the mirrors. And in case the object is placed asymmetrically, here if we join object and all the images, then it will form a rectangle, and the length of this rectangle will be equal to 2 times y units, or 2 times the object distance from M to mirror, and the breadth of this rectangle will be equal to 2 times x units, or 2 times the object distance from M1 mirror. Now let's move further to discuss mirrors inclined at acute angles. Here we have two mirrors M1 and M2 such that they both are inclined at an acute angle, and we have an object O placed in between the mirrors. Here we can have two cases. In one case, we have an object placed such that it makes an equal angle with both the mirrors, hence the object is placed symmetric with respect to both the mirrors, or the object will be placed such that it doesn't make equal angles from both the mirrors, hence the object is placed asymmetric with respect to both the mirrors. Now to start with, let's take an example. Here in this case, we have mirrors M1 and M2 inclined at an angle of 60 degrees, and the object O is placed in between the mirrors such that it makes equal angle with both the mirrors, or the object is placed symmetrically with respect to both the mirrors. Now let's form an image of this object from mirror M1. The image will be formed somewhere over here, and let's call this image I1. Also, if the object distance from M1 is x, then the image I1 will be formed at a distance of x units from the mirror M1. Also, as the object is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees from mirror M1, this image will also be inclined at an angle of 30 degrees from mirror M1. Now, forming an image of this object from mirror M2, so here we have an image from mirror M2. Let's call this image I2. And here too, as the object distance from the mirror will be x, so as the object is placed symmetrically, hence the image I2 distance from mirror M2 will also be equal to x units. Also, the object is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees from mirror M2. Hence, this image I2 will also be inclined at an angle of 30 degrees from mirror M2. Also, in this case too, such like when the mirrors are inclined at right angle, there will be some rays incident on mirror M1 such that after reflection from M1, they will again be incident on mirror M2. Hence, the image I1 will act as a source for M2 mirror. Also, there must be some rays that are incident on M2 mirror such that after reflection from M2 mirror, they will again be incident on M1 mirror. Hence, this image I2 will also act as a source for M1 mirror. Now, taking I1 as source for M2 mirror, let's form an image. Here, the image will be formed behind the M2, and let's say the image is formed somewhere over here. Let's call this image I3. Also, we can see that the total inclination of I1 image from mirror M2 is 30 plus 60, that is 90 degrees. Hence, this image I3 will be inclined at an angle of 90 degrees from mirror M2. Now, taking I2 as a source for M1 mirror, let's form an image. The image will be formed somewhere over here. Let's call this image I4. Here also we can see that the image I2 is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees plus 60 degrees from mirror M1. Hence, the total inclination of I2 image from mirror M1 is 90 degrees. So, the image I4 will also be inclined at an angle of 90 degrees from mirror M1. Also, this I4 image formed is from M1 mirror and is still in front of M2 mirror. Hence, this will again be act as an object for M2 mirror. And the I3, it is formed by M2 mirror, and this I3 image is again is front of M1 mirror. Hence, this I3 will also again act as a source for M1 mirror. Also here, this I4 image acting as a source for M2 mirror means that there must be some rays incident on mirror M2 such that after reflection, they will be incident on mirror M1. Then again, after reflection from M1 mirror, again these rays will be incident on M2 mirror. And in this case, the I4 will act as a source for M2 mirror. And I3 here acting as a source for M1 mirror means that there must be some rays incident on M1 mirror such that after reflection from M1 mirror, they will be incident on M2 mirror. Then again, after reflection from M2 mirror, these will incident on M1 mirror. And this is how the I3 will act as a source for M1 mirror. Now taking I4 as a source for M2 mirror, let's form an image. The image will be formed somewhere over here. Let's call this image I5. Also here, the inclination of image I4 from mirror M2 is 60 degrees plus 90 degrees. That is total of 150 degrees. Hence, this image formed will also be inclined at an angle of 150 degree from mirror M2. Again, here in this case, taking I3 as a source for M1 mirror, let's form an image. The image will be formed somewhere over here, and here in this case too, the inclination of image I5 from mirror M1 is 90 degree plus 60 degree, that is 150 degree. Hence, this image form will also be inclined at an angle of 150 degree from mirror M1. Also, this angle is measured in clockwise direction. Now, to measure the inclination of this image from mirror M1 in anti-clockwise direction, we have to subtract 150 degree from 360 degree. And here we have 60 degree as the angle between the mirrors. Hence, to obtain the inclination of this image from mirror M2 in anti-clockwise direction, we have to subtract 60 degree from this 210 degrees, and it will come equal to 150 degrees. Hence, this image here again is inclined at an angle of 150 degree from mirror M2 in anti-clockwise direction. And here in this case, also we have image inclined at 150 degree from mirror M2 in anti-clockwise direction. Hence, this image will also be I5, or these two images will overlap. Now, in this case, the I5 image formed is behind the mirror M1. Hence, it will not act as a source for M1 mirror. Also, this image I5 is behind M2 mirror too. Hence, it will not act as a source for M2 mirror. So, I5 will be the final image formed. And the total number of images formed in this case will be equal to 5, as the final two images are overlapping. Now, in this case, the images I1 and I2 are formed when a ray from the object interacts with the mirror. Hence, these I1 and I2 are formed by only one reflection. For images I3 and I4, these are formed when this ray, after reflection from one mirror, is again incident on another mirror. Hence, I3 and I4 are formed by two reflections. As for image I5, this is formed when this reflected ray from one mirror incident on another mirror, and this will again be reflected such that it will again be incident on other mirror. Hence, I5 image is formed by three reflections. Also, here in this case, the object and the image are at an angle of 60 degree apart, and the angle between subsequent images are also 60 degree. Hence, if we join object and images, then it will form a regular hexagon. Now, just as in case of parallel mirrors, where we have used a table to find the image distances from both the mirrors, here too, in case of inclined mirrors, we can use a table to get the inclination of images formed from both the mirrors. The only difference is, here, if we have infinite length of mirrors, in case of parallel mirrors, we have infinite number of images formed. But in case of inclined mirrors, if we have infinite length of mirrors, then too, the total number of images formed will be finite. Such like in this case that is discussed already, here we have total number of images formed equal to 5. Now, let's use a table to solve this problem. In the first column, we have image angle from mirror M1, and in the second column, we have image angle from mirror M2. Now, here, the first image from mirror M1 is formed at an angle of 30 degree. Hence, here we write 30 degree. Also, this image I1 formed will act as a source for M2 mirror, and the image formed from mirror M2 using this I1 image as an object is image I3. Also, the inclination of I3 image from mirror M2 is 90 degree, or we can also get this inclination by adding 60 degree, that is the angle at which both the mirrors are inclined to this image angle 30 degree. This I3 will again act as a source for M1 mirror. Hence, the next image from mirror M1 will be formed at an angle of this 90 degree plus 60 degree, that is 150 degree. Also here, we have first image I2 formed from mirror M2 at an inclination of 30 degree. Hence, here we write 30 degree. And this image I2 is acting as a source for M1 mirror. Hence, the image formed using this I2 image as an object for M1 mirror is I4, which is inclined at an angle of 90 degree. Or we can get the inclination of image I4 by simply adding 60 degree to the inclination of first image from mirror M2. And here we have next image formed at 90 degree. Also, this image I4 formed is acting again as a source for M2 mirror. Hence, the image formed using this as an object is I5. So, the I5 will be inclined at an angle of 90 degree plus 60 degree, that is 150 degree from mirror M2. And if we move further, then using this image I5 as an object, we have next image formed from M1 at 210 degrees. And using this image here as an object for M2, we have next image formed from M2 at an angle of 210 degrees. But here, we have already discussed that I5 is now behind the mirror and it will not act as a source for any of the mirrors. Hence, these two images at 210 degrees will never be formed. So, while using table in case of inclined mirror, we have some rules to be followed. And the rule number one is, when the image angle reaches 180 degree, then we have to stop the table. Or in other words, we can say that the image angle will always be lesser than 180 degree. If any of the image angle reaches greater than or equal to 180 degrees, then that image will never be formed. Also here, in this case, we have the last two images formed at 150 degrees from both the mirrors overlapping. Hence, while using table to see if the last images will overlap or not, we have another rule. It says that the sum of last two images formed with respect to both the mirrors and the angle between the mirrors should be lesser than 360 degrees for distinct images. Here in this case, we have last two images formed at 150 degrees. So, the sum of both these images and the angle between the mirrors comes equal to 360 degrees. Hence, these two images will overlap. Also, as these two images are overlapping, hence we can use either of these two tables as a solution for this problem. Now, to summarize the rules to be followed while using the table in case of inclined mirrors, we have first rule as the table should stop before the image angle reaches 180 degrees or the image angle will always be lesser than 180 degrees. And the second rule is the sum of last two images with respect to both the mirrors and the angle between the mirrors should be lesser than 360 degrees for distinct images. Now let's generalize the use of table in case of inclined mirrors just as we did for parallel mirror. Here we have two mirrors M1 and M2 inclined at an angle theta and an object is placed in between the mirrors such that it is inclined at an angle alpha to mirror M2 and at an angle beta to mirror M1. Now the first image from M2 mirror will be formed somewhere over here. Let's call this image I1. Also this image will be inclined at an angle alpha with respect to mirror M2 and this will act as a source for M2 mirror, M1 mirror. Hence, the image formed using this I1 image as an object for mirror M1 will be somewhere over here. Let's call this image I2 and this will be inclined at an angle of alpha plus beta, that is alpha plus theta. Now, as in this case, the first reflection is from mirror M2. Hence, the first image is formed from mirror M2. And to calculate the image angle for subsequent images, let's form a table. Here we have first image from mirror M2 at an angle alpha. Then this image will act as a source for M1 mirror. And the next image will be formed from mirror M1 at an angle of alpha plus theta. And this will now act as a source for M2 mirror. Then next image will be formed from mirror M2 at an angle of alpha plus theta, that is alpha plus 2 theta. Then this will again act as a source for M1 mirror. Then the next image will be formed from M1 mirror at an angle of alpha plus theta, that is alpha plus 3 theta. Now, let's say in this case, we have first reflection from mirror M1. Hence, the first image I1 will be formed from mirror M1 at an angle of beta. Then this will act as a source for M2 mirror. Hence, the image formed using this I1 image as an object for M2 mirror will be inclined at an angle of beta plus alpha, that is beta plus theta from mirror M2. Now, in this case, we have first reflection from mirror M1, hence first image is formed from mirror M1. And to find the image angle for subsequent images, let's form a table. Here we have first image from mirror M1, then this will act as a source for M2 mirror. Hence, the next image will be formed from mirror M2 at an angle of beta plus theta. And this will again act as a source for M1 mirror. Hence, next image will be formed from mirror M1 at an angle of beta plus theta, that is beta plus 2 theta. Then this will again act as a source for M2 mirror. The next image will be formed from mirror M2 at an angle of beta plus 2 theta plus theta, that is beta plus 3 theta. Also, there will be simultaneous image formation from both mirrors M1 and M2. So now form a table to get the solution to this problem. Here we have image angle from mirror M1 and in next column we have image angle from mirror M2. First image from M1 is at beta, then the next image will be from M2 at beta plus theta, then next image from M1 at beta plus 2 theta and next image from M2 at beta plus 3 theta. Also, first image from M2 will be at an angle alpha, then next image from M1 will be at an angle alpha plus theta and next image from M2 will be at an angle of alpha plus 2 theta, and next image from M1 will be at an angle of alpha plus 3 theta. Also here, in this case, we have to follow both the rules. Now to further understand this concept, let's solve a question. Here we have to find the location of images, and it is given that the object is placed at an angle of 45 degree from mirror M1, and the mirrors are inclined at an angle of 60 degree. As given, the object is inclined at an angle of 45 degree from mirror M1, and both the mirrors are inclined at an angle of 60 degree. Hence, the object inclination from mirror M2 will be 15 degrees. Now let's form a table to solve this question. Here we have first image from mirror M1 at 45 degrees, and this will act as a source for M2 mirror. Hence, the next image from mirror M2 will be at an angle of 45 degrees plus 60 degree, that is 105 degrees. Then next image from mirror M1 at 165 degrees. Now the first image from mirror M2 will be inclined at an angle of 15 degrees, and this will act as a source for M1 mirror. Hence, next image from mirror M1 will be inclined at an angle of 75 degrees or 15 plus 60 degrees. Then next image from mirror M2 will be inclined at an angle of 135 degrees. Now if we form further images from both the mirrors, then from M1 it will be at 195 degrees and from M2 it will be at 205 degrees. But these two images angle are greater than 180 degrees. Hence these two images will not be formed. Also, to check if the final two images are overlapping or not, we have to follow the rule number 2, and the sum of both the last images and the angle between the mirror is coming equal to 360 degrees. Hence, these two images will overlap. So, the solution for this problem will be either this table or this table. We can use either of these two tables as a solution for this problem. Now, in case of inclined mirrors, to calculate the total number of images that will be formed from both the mirrors, we have some formulas. Let's say we have two mirrors such that these both are inclined at an angle theta. Then to calculate number of images, we first have to calculate 360 by theta. And if 360 by theta comes even, then we have total number of images formed equal to 360 by theta minus 1. Here we may have two cases. In first case, we may have the object placed symmetrically in between both the mirrors, such that here in this case we have angle alpha equal to angle beta, or we may have object placed unsymmetric between both the mirrors, such like in this case we have angle alpha not equal to angle beta. But if 360 by theta is coming even, then for both of these cases we have total number of images formed equal to 360 by theta minus 1. Now if we have 360 by theta coming an odd number, then for both the cases, that is the symmetric placement of object and the unsymmetric placement of object, we have different number of images formed. In case when the object is placed symmetrically, the total number of images formed will be equal to 360 by theta minus 1. And if we have the object placed not symmetrically between the mirrors, then the total number of images formed will be equal to 360 by theta only. Now let's solve a problem using these formulas. Here we have to find the location of images, and it is given that the object is placed at 30 degree from mirror M1 and at 10 degree from mirror M2. Then the angle between the mirrors will be equal to 40 degree, and 360 by theta is coming equal to 9, that is an odd number. Also here in this case, we have unsymmetric placement of object, or the object is placed unsymmetrically. Hence total number of images will be equal to 360 by theta only, and we have total number of images here equal to 9. Then to find the location of images, we will use a table. Here in first column we have image angle from mirror M1, and in second column we have image angle from mirror M2. Also first image from mirror M1 will be formed at an angle of 30 degree, and first image from M2 will be formed at an angle of 10 degree. Then next image from M2 using this first image of M1 as an object will be formed at an angle of 30 plus 40, that is 70 degree. And next image from M1 using first image of M2 as an object will be formed at an angle of 10 plus 40, that is 50 degree. And we can get further images from both the mirrors by adding 40 degree, that is the angle at which both the mirrors are inclined to the previous images. Here we have next image from M2 at 90 degree and next image from M1 at 110 degree. Then next image from M2 at 150 degrees and next image from M1 at 130 degrees. Now the next image from M2 will be at an angle 130 plus 40, that is 170 degrees. And if we form next image, then it will be at 150 plus 40, that is 190 degree, and this 190 degree is greater than 180 degree, hence this image will not be formed. So these are the angles at which the images will be formed from both the mirrors. Now let's solve another question. Here in this case, we have to find the location of images and the location of images from M2 mirror in anti-clockwise direction. Here it is given that the mirrors are inclined at an angle of 50 degree and the object is placed at an angle of 40 degree from mirror M1 and 10 degrees from mirror M2. Now first we calculate 360 by theta. In this case it is coming equal to 7.2 and it is neither even nor odd. Hence in this case 360 by theta formula will not work and we have to use the table to get the solution to this problem. Now let's form a table. Here in first column we have image angle from mirror M1 and second column we have image angle from mirror M2. Now first image from mirror M1 will be formed at an angle of 40 degree and first image from mirror M2 will be formed at an angle of 10 degree. And to get the further images we have to add the angle at which both the mirrors are inclined. The next image from M2 will be at an angle of 90 degree and next image from M1 will be at an angle of 60 degree and next image from M1 will be at an angle of 140 degrees and from M2 it will be at 110 degrees. Now let's check if both these two images formed at 140 degrees from mirror M1 and 110 degrees from mirror M2 will overlap or not. We add these two image angles from both the mirrors and the angle between the mirrors and it is coming equal to 300 degrees which is less than 360 degrees. Hence we have distinct images. Let's form next image from mirror M2. Then it will be formed at an angle of 190 degrees and here 190 degrees is greater than 180 degrees. Hence this image will not be formed. Now let's form next image from mirror M1. Here we have the image formed at an angle of 160 degrees and 160 is still less than 180 degrees. Hence this image will be formed. And now let's check if these two last images formed, that is from mirror M1 at 160 degrees and from mirror M2 at 110 degrees will overlap or not. So here we add the image inclination from both the mirrors and the angle at which mirrors are inclined and it is coming equal to 320 degrees which is still lesser than 360 degrees. Hence these two images formed will not overlap. Also if we form further images then image angle will come greater than 180 degrees. Hence further images will not be formed. So the solution for this problem will be this table. Now to find the image angle from mirror M2 in anti-clockwise direction. Here we can see that all the image from mirror M2 will be formed in anti-clockwise direction only. Hence these image angle are itself in anti-clockwise direction from mirror M2. Also all the images formed from mirror M1 will be in clockwise direction. Hence these will be in clockwise direction from mirror M2 also. Hence to find the image angle with respect to M2 in clockwise direction we have to add 50 degree, that is the angle between the mirrors in all these images angle. Then we can get the image angle from mirror M2 in clockwise direction. And to get the image angle in anti-clockwise direction we have to subtract these image angle from 360 degrees. Now the image angle from mirror M2 in anti-clockwise direction will be first 10 degrees, then 90 degrees, then 110 degrees, then for 40 degree we have 360 minus 40 plus 50, that is 270 degrees, and for 60 degrees we have image angle 250 degrees, then for 140 degree from mirror M1 we have from mirror M2 in anti-clockwise direction in 170 degrees, and for 160 degrees we have the image angle 150 degrees from mirror M2 in anti-clockwise direction. Now to arrange in increasing order all these angles we have 10 degree, 90 degree, 110 degree, 150 degree, 170 degree, 250 degrees and 270 degrees as angles when the image angle is measured in anti-clockwise direction from mirror M2. Now we have some questions for practice. In this question we have to find the number of images formed and their distances from both the mirrors. It is given that the mirrors M1 and M2 are parallel to each other and the distance between the mirrors is 10 mm. Also, the object is placed at a distance of 2 mm from mirror M1 and mirror M1 is above this line given and mirror M2 is below this line given and these both mirrors extend to infinite length. In next question, we have to find the number of images formed and their distances from both the mirrors. In this case, we have two mirrors, an M1 and M2 inclined at right angle. And it is given that the object distance from mirror M1 is 10 mm and from mirror M2 is 20 mm. Now, in next question, we have to find the total number of images and the location of images from both the mirrors. And we also have to find the location of images from mirror M2 in anti-clockwise direction. Here, it is given that the mirror M1 and M2 are inclined at an angle of 120 degrees and the object is placed such that the inclination of object from mirror M1 is 105 degrees. Now, in next question, we have to find distance of point P from A such that the ray of light will hit the wall AB at midpoint. Here, in this figure, the mirror M1 and mirror M2 are parallel and it is given that both these mirrors extend to a length of 10 mm and one of the ends of both these mirrors, a wall AB, is attached. And we have to find the location of point P such that if the ray of light enters and is incident on any of the mirror and after final reflection from point P, this ray reaches this wall AB at the midpoint. And we have to find the location of point P such that this final ray reaches after reflection from point P to the midpoint of wall AB. Now in the next question, we have to find the length of bright path on wall AB. Here it is given that the mirror is expanded to a length L and a light source is placed at a distance of X units from one of the end of mirror M1. And we have to find bright path that this source will produce on wall AB. Now in this question, again, we have to find the length of bright path on wall AB. Here, in this case, the mirror expands to a length L and a light source is placed at a distance of X units from one end of the mirror. Also, here the wall AB is at a distance of Z units from the other end of the mirror. Hello students, thanks for watching our video and please leave your questions, queries and comments in the comment section below. And if you do like our video, then please subscribe to our channel to be regularly updated with the latest uploaded videos. Thanks.